Good morning guys, welcome back to another video. And as you can see, there is a new location since I am in Stockholm, but we're gonna talk about that in another video. Today I would like to talk about some ways, some advice to save money when you live abroad or simply to save money in general. The first advice I can give is to meal plan and to shop once a week. First of all, because if you don't have a supermarket close by, or if the supermarket you have is quite expensive, you need to take public transports. So in order to not take it twice, and to pay consequently twice for the public transports, you can go once a week, do a bigger grocery shopping, and plan all your meals for the week. Moreover, you can stay on track with your diet, because you know exactly what you're gonna eat that day. You probably live in a country where the currency they use is different from the currency of your hometown. For instance, you live in UK, where they use British pound, but the currency of your hometown in Italy is euro. So when you wanna send money abroad to your family, or vice versa, they want to send money to you, banks can be quite expensive, because usually they add a markup to the exchange rate. But there is a solution for that. I personally use TransferWise, there is the link here in the description, to send money abroad. The advantage of this is that they use the real exchange rate, the one you see on Google, so consequently it can be up to 8 times cheaper when you want to send money abroad. And I'm not alone, over 8 million people worldwide already use it. Click the link in the description to discover more. Nowadays we buy online many things from different websites. What if you could save money using coupons online? On Amazon, Zalando, or on that website that you really like. If you haven't already, just use Honey. The company has been bought recently by PayPal for $4 billion. When you shop online, it finds the best coupon for you and it applies it automatically. Click the link in the description to discover more. The fourth advice I can give you is about the 30-day rules. Has it ever happened to you that you go out with friends, you see something that you really like, clothes, shoes, or those amazing AirPods, and you just want to buy it? My advice is to go home, to wait a bit, to look at the clothes you already have, to look at the shoes you already have, to think about it, probably not for 30 days, but you understand the principle, and then if you really find it necessary, just go and buy it. The principle here is to understand if you really need it. The fifth tip I can give you is about comparing prices. When you want to get a new plan for your phone or for the electricity at home, you should always compare the prices. If you live in UK, for instance, there is Uswitch, which you can find the link in the description, which allows you to compare the prices of phone plans, electricity bills, etc. And this will help you to save some money while getting the same product or the same services. Number six is about to go out and try. You are in your new neighborhood, in your new city, and you just found a lovely coffee shop. The point is that the coffee is good, but it's €4 for an Americano. So what can you do? Is to go out, go a bit farther, and look for another coffee shop, which might be smaller, might be hidden, but it might have the same good coffee and it might be cheaper. You don't need to get stuck with the same shops just because you get in the routine. Or even better, to save more money, you can make your own coffee at home. But you understand the principle, to find new places, and this will save you a lot of money, trust me. Last but not least, look at your expenses. When I was living in London, I had so many subscriptions that I didn't even use. For instance, I had the gym membership from my old gym. Even though I was going in a new gym now, because I was living in another apartment, so I simply canceled that gym membership. Another example is about Netflix. When I was living in London, I didn't really have so much time to watch movies, TV programs, because I was studying. So I simply canceled that subscription for Netflix. Just go through your bank account and look at your expenses, and you might be surprised at how many things and how many subscriptions you have that you don't even use. So these were some tips to save money when you live abroad, or in general to save some money. Let me know in the comments if you already use some of these advices, and if you have other advice, just write it in the comments so you can help other people to save some money. Don't forget to share some love, follow me on Instagram, there is the link down in the description. See you in the next video guys, bye!